You know, you may not know this, but Jordan is actually living a real life love story. My endless love. That's right. His wife and stepsons stuck on the other side of the world. Jordan stuck here, stuck away from each other. At first, it was just the immigration stuff because, you know, well, you met online.
Yeah.
You fell in love with this woman named Leanna.
Mm-hmm.
You quickly moved from the website to WhatsApp to sending each other voice notes. And the next thing you know, they're married.
Yeah.
And Jordan has two new stepsons.
I went to Vladivostok for half a year. But I mean, yes.
Do you want me to give every detail or am I trying to get to the point here?
Yeah, okay. My endless love.
And you know, at first it was just the immigration that they had to deal with. How long would it take with the applications and the approvals and the thousands of dollars and the lawyers? And oh my God, you can only imagine what that's like. But now, with this pandemic, it's literally, when will the borders open up? When can I even visit, let alone for them to move here? But when can you actually see each other again?
Yeah, that's the thing.
I feel for you, man. It's a thing. But the reason I bring this up is not to make you sad.
Really? Really?
I want to highlight your new parenting skills.
Okay.
Because you're now a parent. I mean, I've mm-hmm. never known you as a parent ever, known you most of my life, but here you are, seeing you in this new role. I'm trying to give you a compliment here. Seeing you in this new role actually it's so impressive. It's so inspiring.
Okay, inspiring. I was hoping for that word.
The way you've handled it is amazing, and you're actually like you're step-parenting basically through WhatsApp. I mean, it's wild.
And FaceTime.
And yeah. FaceTime, yeah, of course. Online, you're streaming. You're a streaming stepdad. I mean, that's
a new thing.
That's a new thing. And you're doing an amazing job because I know that your boys are trying to learn English in anticipation of moving to Canada. They're so pumped to come to Vancouver. And I know you walk around town and shoot videos and, you know, showing them Granville Island and showing them all these places. And I've been with you and it's amazing.
Yeah.
And I love the creative way you've helped to motivate them to learn English without it feeling like hard work for them.
Peter, the youngest, the 8-year-old, he's not very good at English. In fact, he's just learning. Whereas Oleg, he knows English way better.
And Peter, Oleg is older. He's 11, right?
Right.
Okay.
So Oleg's 11. Peter's 8. Oleg is really good at English. Though in Russia, they teach them English words, like British words.
Mm-hmm.
Like he'll say trousers instead of pants, which is like he's a time traveler, right? From like 1896. I told him, I'm like, you can't say trousers when you're in Canada. They're going to look at you like you are an actual time traveler.
Right, right.
So say pants or jeans or... So yeah, what I did, because, you know, you want to get them to learn English and to feel comfortable and have it fun.
So what's this idea you came up with?
So I came up with an idea where any movie they're watching, give me a review, like a voice note, WhatsApp review of it in English.
Amazing idea.
So they have just recently watched Sonic the Hedgehog, which is now streaming. Everybody's at home. They're self-isolating as well. So they both gave me a movie review in English for Sonic the Hedgehog.
Hello, Jordan. Elena said that you asked us to tell you about Sonic. So, it was very, very cool. There was Jim Carrey with a bad guy. He always did mistakes to Sonic and Mr. Donut. So it was very, very nice. Peter and I loved it. And we know that in first they did the Sonic and people didn't like it. And so they need to do all again on 3 months. Yeah, goodbye.
So good. He's great.
Here's Peter. Peter now is not as good at English as his brother.
He's eight. Okay.
And here's his movie review for Sonic the Hedgehog.
Hi, Jordan. Very good, Sonic. I like this film. Bye.
Short but sweet. You know what?
Man.
He did his thing.
It's amazing. Dude, I hope that hearing their voice on the air this morning brings you... Some comfort.
Okay.
No.
Okay.
Come on, cry.
I hope
Come on, cry.
Everybody listening appreciates Kid Carson's production and creativity.
I actually thought you were going to say, I hope everyone here appreciates their families. But no.
Oh, well, yeah. No. I could say, yes, I should have said that.
I hope that everyone appreciates the production on this radio show.
Okay. I should have said, everybody. No, seriously, though. Seriously. Hug your family, yeah, and especially.
It's too late now.
Okay.
Okay.
The Kid Carson Show.
We love it.
On Z 95.3.